Thanks. Usually what we do, we talk about the integration of MISP and ATT&CK together. So from the early beginning of what we have seen in ATT&CK, we are strong believer in ATT&CK and what is the evolution nowadays. I'm glad to have seen what Rich did regarding the updates and the sub-techniques and so on. Maybe there will be some challenges regarding namings and so on. But today we really want to see that ATT&CK and MITRE ATT&CK really change the model of thinking regarding matrix-like ATT&CKs. What we have seen is nowadays is more and more people are basically using ATT&CK on MISP and all the sharing communities. It's becoming kind of standard baseline for contextualizations. So usually nowadays, if you see an event without ATT&CK, people are like, oh, it's not good. You need to basically use ATT&CK. So it's really growing. As it's keep to be really simple to understand, even if you can have some, you know, ambiguity on some techniques, it's simple to use. And another thing that is very interesting is for the ingesting of data, it's becoming easier to map those to techniques and so on, so it's really interesting. What we see is a lot of analytical use cases are popping up because we have more and more data, and it's improving risk assessment, threat intelligence, and so on, so, which is quite important for us. And then what we wanted to do is really to more capitalize on this success, especially for MITRE ATT&CK and for other matrix-like techniques.
Yeah. So basically, I mean, one of the things that we also tried to do was, and this goes back to what Richard has just said with the reporting of sightings of these ATT&CK techniques in our communities, is to make that easier for our communities out there. So with MISP, we're basically running a system that is self-hosted by different organizations. We don't have control over anything but a small part of the data out there. So we wanted to enable other organizations to be able to feed this data back. So we highly encourage everyone to use this new system that we have in MISP. So basically, if you can run all your search queries as you did before and just get ATT&CK sightings out of it as a response. So what we're doing as well is this data is highly anonymized. You're basically just getting a counter on the techniques that you're seeing in your community. And the idea is take it based on the time frame since your last reporting, for example, and send that information to MITRE so that they can basically aggregate this information and share it out with the community. So for us as well, having this basically high-level information of what techniques are on the rise in the larger community out there than what we have direct oversight over is really helpful when making decisions, basically.
So we really want that people are capitalizing on the ATT&CK like matrix. You know that having heat maps or general statistics is great, but you can go a bit even further. So what we introduce in MISP is basically a full-blown output format, which is basically the HTML navigator like map. So that means you can do any query, search query that you are used to do through the API, and you directly output them into an HTML with a heat map. So you can really build new tools, new software, and so on by integrating this into existing web applications, which is, I think, quite useful nowadays. Things that are very interesting too is you can really focus on specific sector of activities. Rich mentioned that we need to focus on specific sector of activities to basically have better analytics per sector. When you start to have, for example, taxonomies with a specific sector of activities, you can filter out on the ATT&CK techniques and at the same time the sector, and you can get the exact output that is really mapping what your community is doing. Same with the time frame. And then you can start even to compare those one. So I think we have an example on that. So where you can basically see that this one is, for example, you can get the full data set. So it's a classical heat map that you see from a MISP instance, but you can really apply any filter and then basically have a specific one that is really in a specific given time.
Yeah. So for example, here in this example, what we've done is we've basically gone through a time frame and we said, in this past 2 months, show me all of the ATT&CK techniques that my community has seen in the various events. So it's normalized to, we try to filter out the noise. So if for those familiar with MISP, if you're appending a lot of techniques on the attribute level, don't worry about it. We're normalizing on one technique per event, basically. So the idea is we want to have like an overview of how frequently these techniques are appearing in the community and then run filters against it. How often does it appear, for example, in my own organization? How often does it appear in a sector from the community that we're attached to? For example, if I'm interested in the healthcare sector, let's see all the healthcare organizations, let's see what they're facing, and overlap it then with basically a different sector and compare the two and contrast the two.
So, yeah. So, and then there's a kind of co-effect from this community, and especially that when we did one of the first meeting, we saw a work done by someone from ING, it's Francesco Abigalera. What he did a kind of showcase of using financial techniques into a matrix-like things. And when we saw it, it was like, oh, that's really cool. We should do exactly the same for any matrix-like data set. So the thing is, what we have seen is really relying on the framework of ATTAC, but we should go a bit further. So which we discussed with Francesco, so we look at his Excel table, and we say, okay, we just map it as a JSON file into the galaxy, like we do with Maitre ATTAC. And it's becoming generic. So another thing that has inspired us to do some others, and nowadays we have even additional ones. So ATTAC for Fraud is the first one that was basically triggered by ING for the financial fraud. We get already external contribution on that one. And then now we have additional ones. So for example, there's a one about elections. This one has been the mapping of the existing electoral group at the European Commission that they were talking about elections. So it's basically the exact mapping. John Lambert from Microsoft did an excellent list of his 365 exchange techniques describing the different steps or to gain access to Office 365. So we basically just use this Excel sheet and map it into MISP. And recently we got a contribution from, I don't know if you know that one, Amit. This one is pretty cool. It's not really our field of expertise, but what we have seen is really a nice model to map misinformation and so on. There are some interesting use cases there. So it's really a first step to see how we can work on that.
Yeah, basically the interesting thing was that, first of all, ATTAC has revolutionized for us the way that we express the attacker techniques. But one of the things that it also did as a side effect was really have a very nice consistent way for us to represent contextualization in general. So one of the advantages we've immediately seen with ATTAC out there was that we get these heat map representations of first individual incidents. So we can go in an incident itself and see, okay, what were the techniques that we were dealing with? We get a high level idea of what we're dealing with without looking at all the technical information already. And then the second thing was that you get these global views on your data set. And then we figured indeed this would make sense for a lot of other types of use cases than what ATTAC covers. And we're trying to enable other communities out there to do the same. So, for example, if you're coming from a different field and you have ideas like this, let us know about it, and we can help you basically encode it into this format and to represent it. So here are some idea examples. So this is the Emmet one, for example. The image is a little bit truncated, but the idea is it works exactly the same as ATTAC. So you get all the same elements out of it.
So before to be kicking out by Freddy, so we will conclude on the different aspect. So the thing is, for us, what we want to go, and that's really the next step, is to improve the MISP standard format that we have for the Galaxy to add those matrix-like enhancements. So like we do usually, it's basically we prototype something, test if it works, do an implementation, and as we have seen nowadays that the format is very stable, we will extend it in the Galaxy standard format. Maybe we will need to extend it again for the sub-techniques too, but that will be part of the standard. Things with the sightings, the sighting export format that we did was really a first step of usage. What we really want to reach at some point, and I think that's something that we need to discuss with Maitre, is basically to go to common repositories of analytics with all the sightings. Some could be completely public, some can be even private. Basically, for example, in some sector of activities, I don't know, maybe military, for example, they are maybe interested to just have a private repository. So it's something that we are really working on. Something that we really want to see is for the ATTAC matrices that we see, if we see overlap with existing ATTAC, either mobile, pre-ATTAC, and so on, maybe we should work together to be sure that we basically we don't duplicate the work on those aspects. But if we see new matrix slides that are in a different field, we will welcome those, and we are waiting for contribution on that part. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Peut-être qu'il y a des questions. Is there any question? Yeah, Fabian.
Yeah, indeed. I mean, that is what the ATTAC sighting system does. So you can basically just say, yeah.
So not only share it with within their organization or within the
group. That's indeed a good point. Usually, for example, sightings, indeed, you have, and that's something that we completely missed in the slide, but when we see sightings, we have two angles. You are right. You have angles that are basically sighting within your own organizations and between teams. For example, sightings, for example, a risk assessment team doesn't care about your indicators and stuff like that. But you can share back those sightings back to your team that are doing risk assessment to get back the data and so on. So which is make a lot of sense indeed. I don't mention that because usually we talk about the full stream going back to Maitre, but you can use them, and I think, except if Rich is contradicting me on that, but I think the sightings has been done too for internal exchange too. So you can cite back into information into organization and teams or business units. That makes sense indeed. Good point.
Can this be shared back in sort of MISP-to-MISP transport? Say, if you wanted to have that visibility at a CSIRT level on a dashboard or something?
Yeah, I mean, it is part of the data that you share in MISP, so this is aggregated from the data, so you get that anyway.
Okay, right. So, yeah. Stupid question then. Thank you.
Okay. Thanks.